Hey folks, you know the Azure Cosmos DB team is constantly delivering new features and improved capabilities for this globally distributed, highly scalable database service. So we try to check in with them periodically to stay up to date. My friend Kirill is back once again to show us what's new in Azure Cosmos DB today on Azure Friday. Hey, I'm Scott Hanselman, and it's Azure Friday. We're here with Kirill Gavriluk talking about what's new in Cosmos. There's always stuff new in Cosmos. You ship like, you just ship. Great stuff. Every month there's something great happening in Cosmos DB.
We try to keep up with our customers.
Yeah.
They keep us on our toes. And it's really great to be here because we did a lot of updates. Mm-hmm. And we haven't talked about them at your show at all. So, a number of things. Number one, as we've mentioned in another episode, believe in love at first sight.
Mm-hmm.
So we've invested heavily in SDKs.
Yep.
We think that if features are great, but if you don't have a good developer experience, features are not very useful. We've recorded an episode about JavaScript SDK, .NET SDK. We're doing the same work for Java SDK and Python SDK, revamping all of them. A number of breaking changes, but hopefully they are worth it. So we've talked about .NET SDK, which is now more intuitive, more idiomatic, more modern, testable, mm-hmm. performant. We've talked about JavaScript SDK on the other episode. For example, here I have a to-do app, yet another one, using the new Cosmos JavaScript SDK. And it's an isomorphic SDK, so you can use it on the server, you can use it on the client. Same SDK.
Ooh.
It supports promises, it supports a ton of new JavaScript features. Much easier to use, much easier to code. And what's really exciting today, we just in a month ago or less, we announced CORS support for accepting requests cross-domain. So now you can talk from this app, as you can see, directly to the service.
Without having to go through any intermediary.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
And we have the security is an interesting question. We have it worked out. We have resource token support, so you can get a temporary token from your app, and mm-hmm. then your client can talk securely directly to the database.
Wow.
And a ton of people do this. We know there is a successful service Firebase that specializes exactly on it. So you can see a number of things here. CRUD, you can read, you can write, you can query. Something very close to my heart. Is you can do on updates, so you can read changes. You can subscribe to changes from the database and get called back when the changes arrive.
You get notified all the way back on the client.
All the way back to the client.
That's cool.
We're getting pretty close to building real-time JavaScript-only apps with the database that is by far more performant, more scalable than any of such offering on the
You promise?
Out there. Yep. good one. The way you set up CORS,
mm-hmm.
you go right here. So here I have Kirill Loves Fridays, my little web app, yet mm-hmm. another to-do app.
Of course, it's a scalable world scale to-do app.
It's world scale, and it works across all regions.
Mm-hmm. Awesome.
As far as you want it.
Okay.
And the way to give this app access to your database is by adding its origin to your database account in the CORS menu item.
Very important. Cross-origin resource sharing, super important.
From there on, you're good to go, and you can talk to your database.
Mm-hmm.
Number two, we do want folks to be efficient, to feel Cosmos DB is friendly.
Mm-hmm.
Cosmos DB is a very highly performant service, so sometimes it can get expensive. We don't want folks to pay more than they really need. So we've done a number of updates, including lowering the price for databases with multiple collections 25 times. So now
25 times cheaper?
You can create, it's 25 times cheaper. We think that it's a good present for New Year.
Well, I've told you before, I've tried to run different things on Cosmos, and you've been very kind to help me run some of my blood sugar information through the Mongo front end for Cosmos, and it's worked great, but it has been for small projects that I work on, cost prohibitive, to be frank.
And we felt it, and we took it to heart. It was not an easy change, but we've made two features available. One of them is now you can create databases
okay.
and provision throughput on a database. and have as many collections as you want in the database.
I see. So rather than per collection pricing, which was difficult for me because my particular application had like 17 collections, you make a logical database that contains collections.
Yep. And for some scenarios, per collection pricing is better because you want to isolate that collection, better take 1 million requests per second and no one should mess with it.
Exactly.
But sometimes we have 100 collections and we don't particularly care about each individual in isolation. We just want the entire database to be performant.
That's my scenario.
And so you can provision now throughput on the database, and we've lowered it down so you can create the database. It's $24 a month, and you can create multiple collections in it and work with it.
This is going to be perfect for me. You've just literally saved me money as I stand here.
Always try.
I appreciate that.
With you and many of our customers. Another important thing is when you develop and test with Cosmos DB, I don't think you want to pay at all.
Yeah, I mean,
I wouldn't want to pay.
You know, I don't know if I would say that publicly, but yeah, that's true. Anytime anything is free, it's better.
And it makes sense, right? Because usually you're not running, you're not earning money yet, you're not running in production. Why should you pay? So there are a number of ways how you can achieve this.
Okay.
We have an emulator, which you can download. You can get it in a container. And run it in the container. You can talk to it remotely, host it on a VM, or you can run it locally.
Really?
And it's a great tool. It's a high fidelity emulator. It's actually it reuses a lot of the same shared code base, and so you can get exact behavior down to it's telling you that you don't have capacity in some region occasionally.
That's so great.
The emulator is available in a container, and we added this cool Azure DevOps extension that allows you to add into your pipeline, run my tests on this emulator. And this extension deploys an emulator on a container, gives you the connection string, Azure DevOps runs this test,
That's huge.
Then scraps it out.
Because I've put all my things on Azure DevOps now, but I have to have a separate Azure Cosmos DB instance just to exist for the purposes of integration testing. And now that goes away.
Exactly. You don't, and it's free, right? It's just you're just running it on Azure DevOps VMs, and we use this in our own development. Mm-hmm. All of SDKs are built and tested continuously. CI runs against this. In fact, we're using Azure DevOps now for CI because it's actually better.
That's great.
I think it's a. I think not. Of course, we have a free sandbox. Try Cosmos DB if you want to just try it out, play with it, which is pretty beefy.
I'm already mentally configuring some Kubernetes stuff with Azure Cosmos running for my dev and test.
We think that this combination enables you this really according to the name of pay as you go experience. Mm. You don't want to pay unless you actually it makes sense for you.
Right. You pay for the value.
And we agree. And we. Try to make it better and better for you. Finally, we've talked a lot about global distribution of Cosmos DB. It would not be a Cosmos DB Azure Friday if we didn't talk about global distribution.
It's true.
The important part is that we've enabled strong consistency mode, something that most folks understand because that's how we've learned when we went to school, that everything is consistent. Mm-hmm. It's very hard to write apps when things are not consistent. Strong consistency, very convenient programming model, and it's available now for multi-region deployments. So I can go and I can make my Cosmos DB data available in any number of regions, and then I can go to default consistency menu and enable strong. Mm-hmm. We have some visualizations that help you understand what does it mean.
And by the way, these visualizations, I saw these recently, they're fantastic. They make a lot of sense. And people should check this out. You've always had some really great things in your Azure Blades.
Thank you. Yes, I think this explains much better than 5 pages of documentation.
Well, I mean, the fact that reads are guaranteed to see the most recent write, that is how we learned, and it's the most intuitive way things should work. And the fact that it's simply a configuration option now is amazing.
But of course, it's a trade-off. So you can go and you can choose among these five settings which consistency model you like, which is better in terms of cost versus performance versus versus consistency equation. That's it. Lots more updates coming. Mm-hmm. Please stay tuned. And we're definitely going to be back.
So people should check out the other episodes that we've done on Azure Friday on Cosmos DB. We talk about all the different front ends on it, on talking to it as if it's Mongo, talking to it as if it's Gremlin, talking to it in different ways. The fact that there's an emulator for you to try locally, develop Cosmos DB on an airplane, and then deploy when you're back and landed, and then put it out into multiple regions. It's just a glorious and fantastic database. I appreciate you coming by.
Thank you.
I am learning all about the great new stuff in Cosmos DB today on Azure Friday.